A little resume from the match.
Pettyneitä tässä ollaan, varmaan ulospäin näkyy. Lähetti hakemaan.
So we are disappointed, as you might see. We went to the match with the idea of playing for the victory, and we didn't succeed.
Aika lailla tuossa. Pari tuli mukaan ja minä ja moni muukin siellä
penkillä. The dramatics of the football were present today with the VAR decision at the beginning of the game. And we were already sure that we get the goal. And we tried to devastate the Russian team. And it was very close. I don't know how could it be affected the whole game, but definitely it would have put more pressure on the Russian team.
Katsotaan tuon peli tarkemmin, että se tietyllä tavalla on tyytyväinen, että saatiin.
Now we will take a closer look at the game, and I was satisfied with the fact that we got more occasions to score than against Denmark. We got many occasions, but we didn't use them effectively.
Puolustuspeliin kokonaisuudessaan suhko tyytyväinen, maali oli huonosti puolustettu ja Venäjä pelasi.
Overall, the defensive game was okay. We had a little slow moment when at the Russian goal, but otherwise it was fine. They got few other good occasions to score.
Tukee sitä, miten toi ottelu päättyi, mutta enemmän odotettiin ylpeä tosiaan tuosta.
And maybe the stats they support the end result of the game in the end.
Kaiken jätti tuonne kentälle. Se on tietenkin vähimmäs.
But I'm proud about the players who gave everything to the pitch today.
Joo, siinä oikeastaan se.
And that's about it.
Steve Douglas, ole hyvä.
Hi, Markku.
Hi.
It's just a question. You mentioned yesterday in your press conference that you had no way of knowing how the incident involving Christian Eriksen last Saturday would affect your players. Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Joo, en oo siitä nyt pelaajan kanssa.
Can I repeat the question? Sorry.
Yeah, I got it.
Yeah, I just wanted to know have you spoken to the players, and did they have any lasting damage from what happened on Saturday?
Joo, ei tässä tullut puhuttua pelaajan kanssa pelin jälkeen, että mitä mä aistin harjoituksesta näin pois.
So we haven't talked about it with the players after the game today. But my sense said that the players have
ennen kaikkea se huentava tieto, että Christian voi hyvin ja
have been taking it okay, and especially the information that Christian is doing well, and the players, they wanted to support him at the process of recovery, and I think it was a beautiful move.
Moi Rive, 20. Miksi otit Teemu Pukin vaihtoon?
So why did you take Teemu Pukki off at the second half of the game?
Mitä muuta ajattelit ylipäänsä vaihtojen osalta, miten se peli eteni siinä toisella jaksolla, kun näytti, että Tommi sai kuitenkin paikkoja aika paljonkin?
And what do you think about the other substitutes in general?
Ollut ennen kisojen valmistautumista ja näin poispäin.
So about Teemu Pukki, you have to keep in mind what's the background for him before the tournament.
Kautta vähän samantyyppinen, mutta nopea.
And we tried to get some fresh speed on the pitch with the substitutes, with Lappalainen. And also the pressing game, we wanted to have some fresh legs
aggressiivisemmin Venäjän pelin avaamista.
To be able to press more aggressively.
Joni Kauko otettiin.
And Joni Kauko.
Syllerillä alkoi pohkeet.
We took him in. Rasmus Schüller started having problems with his legs.
Näinä siinä haettiin ja
sitten and we wanted to get more force to the offensive game as we were trying to score.
Pelaaja sinne, että siinä on ne perusteet.
And we got Raitala in to get more power to the offensive game.
Ja muutettiin ryhmitystä.
And we took Jensen in as well and changed a little bit the positions.
Tällaisia näitä etukäteen aina tulee mietittyä, että mitä voidaan missäkin tilanteessa tehdä.
It is something that you always try to consider beforehand.
Vaikka alkoi käymään vähin, niin puolustusarjoja nostettiin sinne.
And in the end, when the time was running out, we took Arajuuri up. To get some force for the headers and probably play, win some balls. So here's the arguments.
Kuuluukohan tämä mun puhe sinne?
Kuuluu
hyvin.
Hyvä. Näytti siltä, että siinä hyökkäyksiin lähdet varsinkin ensimmäisellä jaksolla, mutta myös toisella, niin riistojen jälkeen, niin ei mennyt ihan nappiin. Että
it seemed that the start of the attacks and the counterattacks is especially after getting the ball at the first half seemed that they weren't as dynamic and fast as they should have been. Why do you think it went so? Was it the tempo of the game or the pressure from the Russian team?
No toi oli ihan hyvä havainto, mäkin tein. Mikä se syy siinä on,
niin why did it go so?
Vaikea nyt heti saman tien sanoa, mutta
so yeah, this is a good point and I also
lähellä se oli. Lähellä se kyllä oli.
I discovered the same thing and it is early to say why was it so?
Tarkoitus oli päästä pelaamaan sinne.
But overall we managed to create many occasions to score.
Et valitettavasti tehot ei ollut sillä tavalla kohdillaan ja turhaan tässä nyt lähtee.
But unfortunately the efficiency today with the scoring occasions wasn't on a high level.
Aika hyvin,
and the defenders of the Russian team, they were able to block our shots and scoring occasions.
Tokalla jaksolla sitten saatiin pidempi pallonhallintajakso.
But overall, the offensive game was okay. At the second half, we got many more occasions to control the ball for longer periods.
0-9-7 Venäjälle ja meille 0-7-2, ettei se 1-1 tasuri niin väärä olisi ollut. Mutta ei tätä tilastolla pelata. Et kysymys on sitten loppujen lopuksi siitä taidosta viimeistä.
But yes, this is not a statistics, game based on statistics, in the end it's all about the skill to score and to defense the scoring occasions.
Anssi Karjalainen, ole hyvä.
Joo, Juba ajoi aika kovaa Toivion tuossa sivurajan lähellä.
So Juba tackled Toivio quite harshly at the end.
Ja mitä sanoit siinä Juballe?
So how is Toivio after that, and what do you think about the tackle, and what did you say to Zuba?
Järkele tulee vauhdilla ja okei, hän näytti, että olkapää.
So yes, it was a quite a hard hit when such a big player comes with such a speed.
Kunnolla kylkeä vastaan, mutta sehän nyt on muuttunut.
And when I was a player, it used to be okay to tackle like that. We were used to very hard tackles. But with the rules and habits today that have been evolving, so I just told Juba that it's not something that you can do today. And he was okay with that.
Olitko Erkki pyytänyt kysymyksen? Ainakin oli käsi täällä pystyssä, niin oliko sulla? Nyt ei näy, no kokeillaan. Erkki Oavi, sulla on ilmeisesti tavoite kysyä. No niin, nyt pitäisi kuulua.
No niin, hyvä. Eli kuuluu tota, se Eriksenin paita asia, viittasit jo siihen, että se oli pelaajien. Ketkä pelaajat erityisesti
keksivät? So about the t-shirt that sent the message to Eriksen, which players were especially the ones who got the idea, and it was a beautiful gesture. So we had a discussion with the captains, and they suggested this, and then I supported the idea. And the special thanks to the team management that were able to make it happen on a short notice. And in my mind, it tells a story about the nature of the team and the players.
Jalkapallon suuremmatkin asiat mielessä ja tämän empatian osoittaminen.
And again today the players, they gave everything, but there's also on the other side some bigger things than football.
Emmanuel Pojan Lepik, ole hyvä.
And it is that the players are able to consider.
Do you hear me?
No.
Yes.
Okay. Markku, you're still alive for the qualification and you've only lost by 1-0. It's not a bad result. Are you confident to get maybe one more point against Belgium and go through the round of 16?
Joo, no se on nyt tavoite, eli tähän peli oli tavoite. Ensinnäkin lähtee voittaa ja tai ainakin pisteitä sitten saada, että jokaisen pelin lähtee.
So this is now the goal. We were already kyllä niin coming to this game with the idea of taking a victory or at least a point.
Oli ihan hyvä ja ehkä jollain tavalla ansaittukin, mutta
Belgia. And regarding how the game went, I think we would have deserved at least one point.
Ihan massiivinen haaste meille tulee. Mutta tämä joukko on osoittanut, että
Belgium is one of the strongest teams of the tournament, so it is a massive challenge for us.
Tavioista huolimatta joukkueessa kova ja
kaikkemme. But the team has showed before that they are able to
ja sitten saadaan tämä
able to
unelmamme toteutettua.
To over to play over their level and can make dreams happen.
Tapio Keskisalo, Pekka Aalto sitten annamme estraadin toiselle joukkueelle. Tapio, ole hyvä.
Two more questions.
Joo, no oliko tuota Venäjän pelaamisessa sulle mitään suuria yllätyksiä tai heidän pelaajavalinnoissa?
Was there any big surprises in the way that Russia was playing or their player choices?
Jollain tavalla odotettavaa, että siellä jotain muutoksia tulee. Okei, Chirkov loukkaantui, se on nyt
so there was, we were expecting some changes and Chirkov was injured, so it was clear that he won't be playing. But after the loss 3-0, we were expecting some changes and that's what they did. But they were playing more or less the way that we were expecting and we had been scouting beforehand.
Niin sanottu kymppialojen linjojen väliin tai sitten antaa niitä keskityksiä.
And they're trying to play long balls between the lines.
Liikkuva joukkue, sieltä löytyy luovuttaja.
And then play the ball from the box, from the wings.
Oletettiinkin.
Ja nyt and actually they were playing sitten, exactly as we were expecting.
Oltaisiin onnistuttu se johtomaali saamaan aikaan, että mitä muutoksia siihen olisi sitten.
And it would have been interesting to see what kind of reaction and changes they would have made if we managed to score at the beginning.
No niin, morjens. Te scouttaatte tietysti tarkasti noin vastustajan ja kaikki pelaajat. Miranchuk tiedetään.
So you're preparing and scouting the players beforehand very carefully. And Miranchuk, who plays with the strongly with the left foot, were you disappointed that he was able to get to use the left foot when he scored?
Mutta tosiaan taitavia kavereita nämä on, ja niin kuin huomattiin monessa muussakin tilanteessa, on sen verran...
They are very skillful players.
Nopeutta, tilanne on
and they are fast as well.
Nopeasti painopistettä siirrettyä, saa sen jalan vapaaksi.
And they can move from one side to another very quickly and get the
koko tilanne ja lähti
their feet open. But we were defensive quite poorly at that moment and we lost the ball just before. And it was a beautiful finishing, I must say, and I give credit to that finishing.
Läpi noin pelaajat
and we weren't able to block it.
Halutessaan saa sitten aina tarkkaa infoa, että joka ikinen pelaaja.
And of course we are scouting each player beforehand and our players will get the information if they want to.